Good evening, and welcome to Haven Community College Theater and the world premiere production of The Blues Brothers. There will be one 15-minute intermission, at which time you can purchase refreshments and souvenirs in the theater lobby. As a courtesy to the performers and your fellow audience members, please turn off all cell phones and pagers. As always, the taking of flash photography and videotaping is prohibited. One final note, no actual crimes were committed in the making of this production. The performance will begin in a few moments. The year was 1963, the time before the hippies, the peace marches, the moonwalk, Watergate, and the Super Bowl. It was a time for Wonder Bread, radio flyers, tail fins, Motown, and Frankie Avalon. The place, St. Helen of the Blessed Shroud Orphanage in Calumet City, outside of Chicago, home of the blues.
Just when he be reaching for it.
Some days I feel the same way, except I ain't getting any bones coming my way. Just my hand smack fruition.
Ain't that the truth?
Well, we've been living there our whole lives, and nobody hardly knows us, even cares about us, except you.
Well, boys, I tell you, old Curtis see a light at the end of the tunnel, and that light be telling him there's something special about you two.
Well, if there is, I don't see it.
That's 'cause you're too close to it. Boy standing with his nose at the storefront window don't see the traffic behind him. But that don't mean it don't be there. You see, you boys are better than friends. You're like brothers. You stick up and you stand up for each other, and that's something money can't buy.
Always wondered if I could have a brother, but no mother, no father. Guess that means no brother.
Well, wait a minute. You and me been hanging around with each other since I can remember. There's no saying we can't be brothers. All we need is the same last name, right?
Right.
Hold on here. What you boys saying? You boys want to be real brothers? We not even related by blood.
Well, not yet. Oh, what's that thing the Indians do with the knife in the hand and...
You mean the thing with the knife in the hand?
Yeah. But I don't have a knife.
Well, I got a hand.
Oh, wait a minute. I got an old guitar string here. This should work.
What you boys doing?
You gotta be our witness, Curtis.
Witness to what?
We're gonna be blood brothers.
Hold on a minute here. If there's gonna be blood here, old Curtis will be getting some kind of trouble. And I don't be needing that now.
Don't worry, it won't be much.
That's what I'm afraid of. Hold on a minute. Boy, what y'all done gone and got me into now? Has that thing been sanitized?
Holy shit! Now you.
Does it hurt?
What do you think? Just do it.
Well, you can do it.
Now we clasp hands, let our blood mix into one.
Good. Think a little.
If it don't hurt, it ain't worth it.
Well, y'all done gone and done it now. Oh, by the power vested in me, by the state of Illinois, as janitor of St. Helens, blessed child, I now pronounce you brothers.
Thanks, Curtis.
Hold on, you might be needing this here. Ain't too dirty either. I ain't used to go on. Oh, boy. Y'all best be getting back. And I've got to make my rounds. You know, Mother Sill Pierre will be checking up on me.
Wait just a minute. If we're going to do this right, we need the same last name.
Well, I never liked mine.
I don't like mine either.
I got it. Since you boys have got the blues in your blood anyway, why don't you call yourselves the Blues Brothers?
Jake
and Elwood Blues.
Come here, boy. Tell you what. You boys get back to bed. Sneak out around 11 p.m.
Meet me down at the old warehouse on Elm Street. Me and the boys will be down there working on some new music. And I'd like you to meet me. Okay?
Sure thing.
Boys, Elwood, Jake, hold on a minute. Now this is just between the four of us.
Who?
You, me, and the Lord.
You got it.
Jake, Elwood! In the name of all that's holy, where have you been? Don't you know it's past lights out, huh? You missed bed check again.
We were just, yes. Trying to pick some flowers for your office. Well, we noticed last time that it could use some color.
That's right. Yeah, they're going through some nasty weeds. Look, our heads are still bleeding.
Well, so they are!
Oh.
Boys, we better put some iodine on those cuts.
Really doesn't hurt that much.
Yeah, they're killing already. It must be a miracle.
Well, Lord be praised. Where are my flowers, huh?
Well, we felt Christ preferred we leave the flowers in their natural setting.
Oh, did he now? You tell me the truth. Where were you?
We already told you. We just lost track of time. It's hell up there in them weeds.
Not only do you lie to me, but you curse and take the name of our blessed Lord in vain. My boys, I should give you one last chance to tell me where you've been.
You tell me the truth, then.
I won't punish you.
We already told you.
Well, I can see you leave me no alternative. Too messy. Perhaps the paddle of truth shall help you remember.
No, not the paddle of truth.
My shit.
Forgive me, Lord, but sometimes the shepherd must flog the flock. Assume the position, my little sinners.
Please, Mom, it'll never happen again.
Forgive them, Lord, for they know not what they do.
Getting paddled by the penguin. Boy, skipping out.
Silence!
My poor butts are tingling. And I want to shout.
Sing with you.
I'm always catching hell for something I've done.
You blasphemers?
But oh well, brother baby, at least we had some fun. We got the ass paddle moves. Oh yeah, the ass paddle moves.
200 Hail Marys.
Everybody spread the news while we nurse our back and blues. Got the ass paddle moves.
May that be a blessing to you. Now, boys, I do hope you'll think about what you've done from here on after. Go to your rooms, and don't forget to say your prayers.
Jake, take these babies up and see what they say. Was Jesus Catholic?
Do we care? The many uses of corporal punishment.
I think we see the problem.
Let's get the hell out of here. We don't have to wait for a bed check.
Now you're talking. I'm eyeing the sweet Shelby over in the next block.
Let's take her for a ride. Who the hell is Shelby?
It's a car. It's a souped-up Mustang with a four-barrel carb, first shifter, and racing tires. This thing was made for speed, but this time, we don't get caught.
Don't worry. Nobody's gonna catch us.
And what the hell are we waiting for?
Wait a minute. I think we're gonna need some company. Like Sherry? She's always game. You get the car, I'll get the girl. Meet me on the corner in 5 minutes.
Hurry up. I hate waiting.
Expecting a crowd here tonight.
Yeah, well, it looks like you brought some friends along, too.
We just just one big happy family here. Just having a good time and playing the blues.
Cool place.
Yeah. So, Sherry, you sweet on her?
We're trying to keep it quiet, but you know how it is.
Man, you can't tell a girl you like her. She'll never leave you alone.
I can see that now.
So, what's she like?
She's not too bad.
I'm not too bad?
You know what I meant, Sherry.
Yeah, we'll see about that later, Jake.
Oh, man, I stay away from girls, so too much trouble.
Hey, fellas, let's get started. Hey, guys, these are two boys I told you about from St. Helens. Hey,
guys, how you
doing? These are some of the friends they brought along with them. Hey, guys. Well, I tell you, boys, we've been working on two R&B tunes, and I think you're going to like it, so just feel free to, jump right on in. Guys, y'all got ready? You bet. Okay.
You've been dancing with all over the neighborhood. So why didn't you ask me, baby? Or didn't you think I could? Well, I heard the boogaloo is out of sight, and the ceiling's a thing tonight. And if there were you and me now, baby, I could have shown you how to do it right. Do it right.
Let's get out of here. report, Sarge. Stolen vehicle, driving without a license, resisting arrest and endangering public property. I'll just add that to your previous record. Last time, we busted you for vandalism, breaking and entering, shoplifting, resisting arrest again, driving without a license again, and destruction of police property. Now, I think it's about time you two spend some time in the cool grounds.
Hot stuff! Just crap! We never hurt anybody. Man, this sucks.
Let's just take it easy and not make things worse.
Yeah, well, we get one phone call, don't we?
Well, who's gonna help us?
Nobody. Curtis?
He ain't got money for bail.
You're right. Who are we kidding?
Get out of here. I'll call St. Helens right now and let them know you're here.
Well, don't bother. They don't know if we're here or not. Damn, did he even say goodbye to sh-
For the next 6 years, despite everyone's best efforts to find ways to make them fit in, the two boys were in constant meetings with social workers, then getting sent to juvenile detention centers, and finally spending time in jail. But there was no change. They seemed destined to live on the fringes of society. Their only escape was their music. And as they got older, Curtis's band became their band. Soon they began getting a reputation for spreading the gospel according to the blues. Despite their best attempts to stay out of trouble, Jake found himself in jail for 3 to 5 years for armed robbery, while Elwood did his best to hold down a regular job. Their Blues Brothers days seemed far behind them. Eventually, though, the time came for Jake's release and the chance for a new start.
See why not?
Because I could definitely use some action right now. You know what I'm saying? Three years.
I got just the thing for you. I got a girl who's been waiting all this time just to see you. Been saving herself for you.
For me?
Yeah, if you're interested, I'll take her to you now.
Tell me more.
She's the type of gal who likes to dress up in those little Catholic outfits you like.
The skirts and stockings?
You could say that. And if you're really bad, she might even beat you. If you're interested, I'll show her to you now.
Who are we talking about?
The penguin.
No. Listen, I told you, there's no way I'm going to see that wacko.
You promised the day you got out you'd go and visit the penguin.
Yeah.
So I lied to her. You can't lie to a nun.
Listen to me. No way in hell.
R267, this is an update on Jake Blues. When checking the accuracy of his parole contact information, we discovered that his address, 1620 West Addison, was falsified. It is, in fact, the address of Wrigley Field. Let's continue to try to contact him to correctly update this information.
Who is it? boys. It's nice to see you. Now please, won't you have a seat? No, boys, closer. Into the light. I want to see your faces. Closer. Closer. You boys look well.
You don't. I mean, you look worried. Something on your mind?
Well, the county took a tax assessment of our property last month. We want $5,000.
Doesn't the church have to pay for that?
They would if they were interested in keeping the place, but they aren't. The Archbishop wants to sell this building outright to the Board of Education.
Well, what's going to happen to you?
I'll be sent to the missions.
$5,000, no problem. Have it for you in the morning. Come on.
No! No, I will not take your filthy stolen money.
Well then, I guess you're really up shit creek.
Ow!
Beg pardon.
What did you say?
I offered to help you. You refused to take our money. Then I said, I guess you're really up shit creek.
Ow! Christ, Jake, take it easy, man.
Shit! Shit! Ow! God damn! Ow! You are such a disappointing bear. I prayed so hard for you. It saddens and hurts me that the two young men whom I raised to believe in the Ten Commandments have returned to me as two thieves with filthy mouths and bad attitudes. Get out and don't come back until you redeem yourself.
Hey, boys, y'all gotta learn not how to talk to nuns that way. I tell you,
Curtis! James!
Oh, you
Elwood!
Boy, man, how are you?
Oh, boys, things are bad. They're gonna sell this place to the Board of Education, and I'm gonna be out on the street. That money's gotta be in the Cook County Assessor's office within 7 days.
They wouldn't throw you out, would they?
Oh, come on, Jake, I'm invisible to those people.
Curtis, you and the Penguin are the only family we got. You're the only ones that was ever any good to us. Singing Muddy Waters tunes and blowing harp for us down here, right?
Well, I tell you, boys, Sister was right. You boys could use a little churching up. Now I want you to slide on down to the Triple Rock Baptist Church, and I want you to see Reverend Cleophas. And boys, whatever you do, please listen to what he's got to say.
Curtis, I don't want to listen to no jive-ass preacher talking to me about heaven and hell.
Jake, wise up. Get to church, please. Come on.
Yes!
Yeah.
I'm a down! thief in the night!
Amen!
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 Well,
amen.
Well, well!
Jake Blues missed his parole meeting today. His brother Elwood listed as his contact is also wanted for 116 unpaid parking tickets and 56 moving violations. Let's put out an APB and bring them in.
So, we'll get the band back together, do a few gigs, make a little bread, $5,000.
Getting the band back together might not be as easy as that, Jake.
What are you talking about?
They split. They all took straight jobs.
Yes, you know where they are. You kept in touch with them.
I got a couple of leads, a few phone numbers, but how many of them visited or even wrote you, huh?
They're not the kind of guys that write letters. You were outside. I was inside. You were supposed to keep in touch with the band. You kept telling me we were going to play again.
What was I going to do? Take away your only hope? Take away the one thing that kept you going in there? I took the liberty of bullshitting you, okay?
You lied to me.
It wasn't lies, it was just bullshit.
What are these leads you got?
Well, last I heard, Terry was playing at some Holiday Inn with a couple other guys in the band.
What are we waiting for? Come on, let's go.
Jake, what about your lifetime ban from all Holiday Inns.
Hey, those chicks said they were 18.
Terry, and these are the two tones. We're going to take a short break right now. When we come back, we'll be doing more great songs for you in the Armada Room's two-hour smooth jazz set. So stick around for a great time.
So, Jake, you're out. You're free. You're rehabilitated. What's up? What's happening? What you going to do? Hey, asshole, where's the money you owe us? Look, let's get one thing straight here. The reason he got locked up in the slammer in the first place was for sticking up that gas station to cover used guys.
You're kidding.
No. He pulled that job to cover the band's room service tab from that Kiwanis gig in Cole City.
That's right. So I don't want to hear any more of this small change shit, okay?
We're getting the band back together.
Band? You guys were the backbone, the nerve center, a great rhythm and blues band. You can make that live, breathe, and jump again. Terry and the Two Tones. Look at you guys in those candy-ass monkey suits. I had a bad Joliet.
Well, at least we got a change of clothes, sucker. You're still wearing the same shit you had on 3 years ago.
Well, you know, Jake, he ain't lying, though. We had a band powerful enough to turn goat piss into gasoline.
Never get that fast sound without more horns. We need a Wild Bill.
Where is he? What about Joe Guitar Gibbon?
No, forget about Joe. He opened up a soul food restaurant, his old lady down on Maxwell Street. He took Wild Bill and my cigarettes with him. Yeah, they're not going to leave those jobs.
Listen, me and the Lord, we got us an understanding.
We're on a mission from God.
Well, if we can get Joe Guitar Gibbon and Wild Bill back, we'll do it.
All right, we'll be in touch. And, get rid of those suits.
Yeah. I don't know, Jake.
What?
I think we're gonna get Bill and Joe.
Ah, come on, let's go. Hey, why don't we go see Maury Slime? Remember Maury?
Sweater chest?
Yeah, finally got the rug, yeah. Remember he got us a lot of those great gigs in the old days?
He's past his prime.
Ah, come on, I got him late. He owes me. Come on. Maury, you owe me. We'll play anywhere, anytime, for anybody.
Yeah, put us in the Double Up Lounge, or the Morgan Park Theater, or the Crystal. We used to knock them dead in those joints.
You mean to tell me you guys got the band back together?
We got everybody except Joe Guitar Gibbon and Wild Bill. We're getting them next.
Oh, who you kidding?
Maury, we got it covered.
I don't know, boys. I just don't know. Times have changed, you know what I mean? Anyway, what are you guys gonna do? The same hair? You're gonna wear the same fakaka suits?
Put the F in fakaka.
You're gonna scare people away. Don't you guys ever wear blue jeans or jumpsuits like Wayne Cochran or CC Riders?
Maury, we need money. We need 5,000 bucks fast.
5,000 bucks?
5,000 bucks.
Who do you think you are? The Beatles? Hey, besides the hall, you guys gotta work to rake in that kind of
dough. We can fill any hall in the country. Come on, what do you got?
You know what you guys ought to do? You guys ought to play colleges. That's the new thing. That's where the action is. You might be able to get yourself a good audience there.
You got any in mind?
Yeah, I got something. Something came down last week. It's a nice place up north. Hipping Community College.
Sounds like a dive.
Hey, don't be a spider.
How far up north are we talking?
Northern Minnesota.
Jesus, Maury, I just got out of state. I got out of the joint. I can't cross state lines.
Look, you guys want a gig or what?
Keep talking.
I figure you play up there, you guys will knock down an easy $5,000.
Okay, book us for tomorrow night.
Hold, tomorrow night? What are you talking about? Gig
like that, you gotta prepare the proper exploitation.
I know all about that stuff, Maury. I've been exploited all my life.
Oh, forget it. There's no way with you guys. Forget about it. You're asking me to do something I promised myself I'd never do.
Yeah, what's that? I'll
work with you guys again.
How's Mrs. Slime, Maury?
I might have some information she'd like to know.
Blackmailing me, Jake?
You want to put it that way? Maury, we need this gig.
We're on a mission from God.
You get us at home, Maury. I guarantee we'll pack them in for miles around. Come on, what do you say?
All right, since I'm a religious man, okay, I'll get you the auditorium, I'll print up the show bills, I'll make sure the joint looks real pretty, okay? I don't think you guys are gonna gross dollar one, but if you do, I want a taste of the gate.
Thanks, Marlon.
Not so fast. I'll do whatever I told you, but on one condition.
What?
You make sure you get Joel Guitar Gibbon and Wild Bill back in the band, and then you got yourselves a deal.
You got it covered, come on. Yeah. Maury, don't touch me.
Yeah.
Doctor with a degree, and don't take too much high, you see.
foot.
You can cancel our